हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज थर्ड पार्ट ऑफ योर थर्ड चैप्टर एंड द चैप्टर नेम इज फाइबर टू फैब्रिक। आई हैव गिवन यू सम होमवर्क एन एक्टिविटी एंड आई हैव गिवन सम वर्ड्स टू सॉर्ट आउट द वर्ड मीनिंग्स। सो आई होप you have done it. Now see the next heading. The next heading is jute. Now jute is a plant fiber, as I told you, and it is the cheapest natural fiber. It is also known as the golden fiber, and it is mostly grown in the West Bengal, Bihar and Assam. Now look here. You can see the jute field are shown here in this figure. Jute is one of the cheapest natural fibers. It is a long, soft, shiny plant fiber that can be spun into coarse, strong threads. Hence, it is popularly known as the golden fiber. Do you know why it is called the golden fiber? Because it is of golden color. That is why it is called the golden fiber. In India, jute is mainly grown in West Bengal, Bihar and Assam. Jute is produced from the stem of the jute plants. Here are the stem of these jute plants. It can be grown in a number of soil types ranging from clay to sandy. It is cultivated during the rainy season and is generally harvested when it is in the flowering stage. It is harvested at the flowering stage. After harvesting, the stems are tied in bundles and soaked in water for 2-3 weeks. The stems are put in the water for 2 or 3 days. Then let's see what happened. Then the fibers are separated by hand from the rotting stems. The stems become rotten and the fibers separated. So we can separate it by hand, using hand. This process is called rotting. So rotting is the process of separation of jute fibers from rotting spin. Now another process is given here, spinning. Process of producing yarn is called spinning. Now look here. The fibers are made into yarn by twisting the strands together. This process of producing yarn from fiber is called spinning. The process of producing yarn from the fiber is called spinning. Uses of jute. Jute is the second most important fiber after cotton. Means jute is the second most important fiber. It is used mainly to make cloth for wrapping bales of raw cotton and to make sacks and coarse cloths. The fibers are also woven into curtains, chair coverings, carpets and backing for linoleum. You can see here, these are the curtains. It is made of jute fiber. Now here are the carpets. This is the rope. Now look here, the tidbit is given here. The world's leading jute producing countries are India, Bangladesh, Nepal, China, Thailand. But India is the world's largest producer of raw jute and jute products. Means we can say that India is at the first position in producing jute fiber. Other useful plant fibers. Now you can see, these are the jute fibers. As you can see, this material is woven from the jute fiber. This is jute. Other useful plant fibers: coir, hemp and silk. Cotton are natural fibers which are obtained from plants. Coir is obtained from the outer covering of the fruit of the coconut palm. As you have seen, the coconut, so you have seen some fiber like structure outside the coconut. This structure is called coir, and this is used in making coir fiber or fabric. It used to make several household products such as ropes. Ropes are made from the coir. Mattresses are also made. Hemp fibers. Are obtained from the stem of the hemp plant. It is used in production of ropes, carpets and paper. Silk cotton is obtained from the silk cotton tree, also called kapok. Silk cotton, the second name of silk cotton is kapok. Remember it. The silk cotton is also known as kapok. It is the second name of silk cotton. Silk cotton is used as stuffing in pillows and sleeping bags. Now look here. Coir is obtained from the coconut palm and it is used in making rope, mattresses and pillows. Hemp fibers is obtained from the stem of hemp plant and used in making ropes, carpets, paper, etc. And silk cotton or kapok is obtained from the silk cotton tree. Now look here, stuffing in pillows. It is used in stuffing in pillows and sleeping bags. Now another next heading is animal fibers. Wool and silk are some common examples of animal fibers. As you can see in the first figure, the man is cutting the hair to obtain wool. This is the threads, bundle of threads of the wool, and this is the wool fabric, and it is this fabric is made by knitting with the two needles by hands. Wool and silk are common some common examples of animal fibers. Wool is the fiber obtained from the hair of sheep and some other animals. Removing the wool from sheep using special clippers is called shearing. After shearing, the wool is cleaned and spun into fiber. This fiber is then woven or knitted to make woolen cloths. Woolen cloths are good for wearing in cold season. Today, India is among the top 10 wool producers of the world. Remember it. India is among the top 10 wool producers of the world. So, obtaining wool fiber is called shearing. This is the process, shearing. Now, uses of wool. You all know wool is flexible, absorbs moisture, and is sturdy and flame resistant. It is used for making the clothing such as sweaters. You can see this is sweater and these are the gloves. All these things are made of wool fiber. It is used for making fine clothing such as sweaters, woolen caps and woolen gloves. It is also used in bedding, upholstery and carpets. Let's see here. Wool is obtained from the sheep, sometimes rabbits and goat also, and the word shearing means removing of wool, and uses of wool are we can make sweaters and woolen caps etc. from the wool. Now let's see the another fiber. Another fiber is silk. Silk is obtained from the cocoon that the silkworm weaves around itself. Do you know what is cocoon? Look, the word cocoon. The silkworm, the first stage of the silkworm in the life cycle of silkworm is egg. Second stage is larva. This is the larva of silkworm. In the second stage is larva. This is the silkworm. First stage is egg. Then first stage is egg, then larva, then cocoon. So it is the third stage in the life cycle of silkworm, and from this stage we find the silk fibers. Silk is obtained from the cocoon that the silkworm weaves around itself. The rearing of silkworm for production of silk is known as sericulture. Silkworm feeds on mulberry leaves. It secretes an unbroken fiber cocoon around itself. The fiber is this one here. The cocoon is boiled in water to kill the silkworm. To obtain the silk fiber, we have to boil. To boil this cocoon in the hot water. Silk is the strongest natural fiber. It was first developed in China. From China, it reached India and other places. So we can see the silk was discovered in China. Now look here. Animal fibers. Wool is obtained from the sheep. Shearing means removing of wool. Uses of wool are, it is used in making sweater, woolen caps, etc. Now next fiber is silk. Silkworm are kept on mulberry trees. They eat the mulberry leaves, and the rearing of silkworm is called sericulture. The cocoon is the third stage in the life cycle of the silkworm, from which we get the silk fiber. And the uses of the silk are velvet. We can make these fabrics, velvet, chiffon, crepe, etc. Now look here. Uses of silk. Silk is very shiny fiber. Silk fiber is made into fabrics such as stain, such as satin, velvet, chiffon, crepe and brocades. Now synthetic fibers. Nylon and polyester are synthetic fiber. They are obtained from the plastic materials which we get mainly from petroleum, or we can say from crude oil. The plastic is first heated to melt it. It is then forced through a device called a spinneret. So, spinneret means, we can see, spinneret means a device used in making synthetic fiber, which contains fine holes. The long threads that come out from these holes and allowed to cool and solidify. These threads are then twisted together to form yarn, which is ultimately used to make fabric. Synthetic cloths are stronger than and do not wrinkle easily. They also dry easily, but they have lesser air space in them than natural fibers. These fibers do not absorb sweat and is unsuitable for use in hot and humid climate. They are often mixed with natural fibers such as cotton or wool to make cloths. These cloths are wrinkle free. But these are the expensive cloth materials, silk. Now look here, the tidbit is given. Coir and silk cotton are some of natural fibers which are obtained from plants. Coir is obtained from the outer covering of the fruit of the coconut plant. Now look here, one activity is also given here. In this activity, the aim is given to identify the nylon fabric. For it, the material required: cotton fabric, nylon fabric and a bowl of water. And the method is given here. Take a cotton fabric and nylon fabric. Soak them in water. We will put these two fabrics in the water. Wring them out and dry them in the sun. Cotton fabrics takes more time to dry in the sun than the nylon fiber. It is because nylon fabric does not absorb water. So this activity you can perform at your home. So students, take the screenshot of this portion by just sliding your two fingers at the down. Now underline some hard words and you have to write the word meanings of those words. Underline here, cheapest. Whereas, popularly, कल्टीवेटेड। हार्वेस्टेड फ्लावरिंग स्टेज। सोक्ड रेटिंग ट्विस्टिंग स्ट्रैंड्स स्पिनिंग रैपिंग लिनोलियम सिल्क कॉटन कपूक स्टफिंग शियरिंग क्लिपर्स producers flexible absorb moisture flame resistant upholstery bedding सेरिकल्चर रियरिंग प्रोडक्शन मलबेरी सीक्रेट्स ककून अनवाउंड Satin, velvet, chiffon, crepe, brocades, polyester, synthetic, spinneret. Solidify ultimately wrinkle unsuitable Okay, now students, take the screenshot of this page as you have to write the word meanings of the underlined words. Take the screenshot and write the word meanings of the underlined words and also read the chapter at home. Okay, students, now write the word meanings. Now we will meet in the next video, fourth part of this chapter. And in the next video, we will do the word meanings and some of the exercises of this chapter. Till then, good day.